sheriff the hard way.
Oh, this is better than dodging those sheriffs in Kentucky. Besides, we might do pretty good here.
Hi, lover. You miss me?
Miss you? I couldn't sleep. Couldn't eat. Couldn't think.
I couldn't even write your muscle bound ache.
Oh, no. Come on, hurry it up. Get flying. You've got the only good-looking pair of legs to show.
Hello, Sue.
Come on.
Over here. We go on tonight. I'll meet you in the cookhouse at 6:30 and give you the rest of the lowdown. Okay? Quiet, everybody. Quiet, quiet.
Shh. Quiet. Just a moment. Now, you all know why we're here in Europe. Back home, we didn't do so good. As a matter of fact, we didn't do anything. They won't look at you freaks anymore, even if we paid them. The only one who came around was a sheriff. Now, this is the first American carnival that ever played Germany. Nobody knows whether they're going to go for us or not. But I figure this way. We might turn into a freak novelty if we give them straight American mud show corn. So forget where you are. Play it straight to the hillbillies. Now, you talkers, you'll have to work in German. I've had translations made of all the ballyhoos. So you read them right out. And if we can't talk them in, pray them in.
You must play the role.
My daughter, Karen, left in Kimberly, lost her kingdom of Greece.
These are the giant highest Krupal. He was worshipped as a god. Outside god by the Dayak tribe of Central Borneo, where he was captured after a terrific battle. Comft. Here we show him as a gesture and the vice, Americanische friendship, to all the people in the world.
Change, meine Damen und Herren. All these remarkable little ladies here, diesen wunderbaren Menschen, perform these their peregrine temperance to the gods of their fathers, the perfect control. Control of the 200 separate and distinct muscles of the 200 muscles of the belly, yeah?
All right, 50 cents, 50 pfennigs.
Only 50 pfennigs, come on. Only 50 pfennigs, boys, and inside works warmer, they don't wear so many clothes.
Come on. Sir, who's next? You are?
Why, yes, sir, thank you. Uncle Shane, step up, sucker. Thank you very much, yes, indeed.
It's all right. I'll show down.
Was verkauft? Aus verkauft.
Come back in half an hour.
A halbe Stunde.
Bitte. I'll call him, Ernie.
Hungry for what? Blood?
I should suck the wound. It may be poisonous.
If you're hungry, why don't you go ahead and eat it?
Cochran, thank you very much.
You speak pretty good English. How come?
Of course I do, Emmy. It's a hangover from the time a girl spoke English or she didn't leave.
Pretty good-looking girl.
So?
You know what might be good for you?
A little time in jail, maybe, for picking pockets.
Some honest work.
You could get me work.
Might get you a job here in the carnival.
I can do anything. I'm very strong. You mean it?
What's your name?
Willie.
Willie?
Willie.
Oh, Willie.
That's not my real name. But someone called me that one time and it stuck.
My name's Joe. Joe Hammond. How are you, buddy?
Pardon me? Joe. I've got some information for you. I did not count your money. I think this must be yours.
Thanks. Willie, remember this. Anytime you ever catch a thief, be sure and search it very thoroughly. Charlie! Charlie! Well, we're doing all right now, huh?
Yeah, we're really going for that Tennessee Dutch.
Oh, this is Willie.
Willie? Here, looks like a girl.
I think she is. You'd like to join up with us, Charlie.
Oh, now listen, Joe, I can't put everybody you pick up on the payroll.
No, look, this is an exception. She's gonna teach me German. You know, to help out with the spiel.
What else can she do?
Now, this is serious. You can put her to work in the cookhouse, washing dishes.
I will do anything, Mr. Grayson. Even a few days' work will help me.
Okay. Sleep her with the answers, I guess. You show up at the cookhouse at 6:30 in the morning.
Thank you, Mr. Grayson.
Oh, don't worry. worry about him. He's harmless. I'm released from an asylum in Alabama.
No, he's just a little stupid. He's a dummy. You know, he can't talk.
Go back to your tent, Ruffo. Go back to your tent. Kid?
Get out of here, you Tom.
Close that door.
Oh, shut up a minute. This is Willie. She's going to stay with you a while. Well, baby, this is your new home. What's the matter? What's the matter?
Look, I've been traveling. I'm not clean. I'd be ashamed for them to see me. Is there some place where I could take a bath?
Sure. I guess the only clothes you own are the ones you got on, huh?
Yes.
Well, I think we can find something for you. Come on.
Which one do I pull?
What do you want, hot or cold?
I want hot.
And then pull the one on the right.
Oh, it's cold.
Well, it takes a little while.
How long?
Jane, and soak yourself.
Oh. Soap is expensive, you know. Oh, so good.
You all soaked all over?
Every bit of it. I'm all smothered in bubbles. I'm all slippery in soap, and it's wonderful.
Then go ahead and rinse off.
I hate to do it.
How do you feel now?
Clean.
You look clean. You smell clean. But you taste clean, too.
No, please.
What's the matter? What's this? You didn't kiss before.
What difference does that make? If I've been married before, would that make you want to marry me? If I've been hurt before, would that make you want to hurt me?
Mm-mm. I don't want to hurt you.
for supper tonight?
Meatloaf.
You're the new guy on the cook tent, aren't you?
How did you guess? What are you doing up there?
Testing the guy wires.
Oh.
Say, I used to pay the other girl a little extra to bring a pot of coffee to my tent right after the act. I'd be okay with you?
Be glad to. You have sugar and cream?
Black.
Mein Damen und Herren, jetzt das Wunder der Wundershow, der Großkolonne. From a height of 110 feet, von einer Höhe von 37 Meter springt dieser mutige Mann in diesen kleinen Tank.
Just put it on the chair. Well, that's real service. How do you say thanks in German?
Danke schön.
Danke schön.
And you deserve it. I saw your dive.
Like it?
Well, you're very brave, but it frightened me.
It'd probably scare me, too, if I saw it from the ground. Ooh, I've got a headache.
Do you get them often?
Once in a while. Depends how I hit.
Will you let me rub your neck for you? I used to be good at it.
All right. You have strong hands.
Hard work makes strong hands.
They always do hard work?
Not always.
Who are you? Where are you from?
That's not important.
Oh, that's wonderful. My headache feels better already. Thank you.
It was a very quick cure.
Would you mind walking across the room, please?
Why? I
want to see how you move, how you carry yourself.
Very well.
Did
you mind taking off your dress?
But sometimes there are phrases in English I do not understand. Did you ask me to take my dress off?
Afraid of me?
I'm not afraid of anyone.
I was thinking?
Probably.
You're wrong. I've been thinking lately the act might go better if I had a partner. That's all. It's just an idea.
A lady partner?
That's right. Can you swim?
Yes. You were thinking of me?
Why not? You've got good legs, good shoulders, strong hands. That's important when you're coming up. You move well. Have good balance?
Yes, but why do you ask me? There are many who move well.
Well, if you don't want to, just say so.
I don't really mean I don't want to. It's just that I'm scared to death just thinking about it.
I know. I used to be that way myself. But I found you can do anything you make up your mind to do. Here, for the coffee.
Oh, thanks.
Why don't you think about it for a while?
I would be able to earn a great deal of money, wouldn't I?
A lot more than you're making in that cook tent.
A lot more?
Ah. Think it over.
I will. Good night.
Good night.
Joe.
Oh. Hello, Willie. What's this? Bedside service for the great Coloni?
Yeah. And, he said something tonight that I want to ask you about.
What?
He wants me to be his partner. In the diving business, he said he'd teach me.
Well, maybe he's on the make for you.
Oh, no. No, he's very serious. He said I'd be able to earn a lot of money.
What'd you tell him?
Well, he said I'd need a little time to think about it. I thought I'd better ask you first.
Ask me? Why?
See whether you mind it or not.
Mind it? Baby, you've been overdue for a good break. Do you think I'd stand in your way?
No, no, no. I know you wouldn't, but it's very dangerous, you know.
Ah.
I'm afraid.
Look, people get killed every day in the bathtub. Anything's dangerous.
You really think I could do it?
I know you can do it. But listen, you... I don't want that Wisconsin cheese eater moving in on my girl.
Glad you're jealous.
Sure, I'm jealous. I gotta go check with Charlie about the receipts. See you later. Night.
Good night. Even 10 feet looks high from here.
It is.
Oh.
Lesson number one, never look up. Not even when you're climbing.
Yeah.
Never look up. Now try it. No matter how high you are, take one look down at the tank. Just one. And look straight ahead.
Shouldn't I watch you try it once or twice?
Nope, this is the way to do it. Now look, you watch me. Turn around. As soon as your head touches water, the very instant you feel water, bring your back, pull up like this, and reach for air. If you do that, you won't touch bottom. If you ever do touch bottom from real height, you're gone. Got it?
All right, I'll try it.
All right, you go on out to the end and do exactly what I tell you when I tell you. All right, look down just once. Look straight ahead. Up on your toes. Deep breath. Now fall forward.
Oh,
That's bottom.
Yes, I know, but how was the rest of it?
Terrible. Now go on up there and do a good one.
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir.
Hi. What's need, honey?
Meatloaf. Honey, my cup's dirty.
So is your face, my dear. But we can get a new cup.
Don't you dare grin.
Who's grinning?
Los, abwaschen. Wir brauchen dich hier nicht mehr. Na los, mach schon.
Na ja, ich tu schon.
You'd feel sorry for everything that wears skirts.
It's only 25
For me.
Been in a fight?
Yes. You guess with whom? I don't like it. Whistling for me. Like for a dog. You never let me know ahead of time. You never take me out. You just call for me as if I were your servant.
Baby, what kind of a beef is this? You know I'm busy. I don't know when I'm going to be free.
Well, from now on, you have to find out. You must treat me like a person of feeling instead of...
Instead of what?
Instead of what you think I am.
Baby, I think you're my girl. Anything wrong with that?
You shouldn't be so certain.
Can't help it if I'm certain. Come on, let's take a walk, huh?
No.
What do you mean, no?
I think you are falling for that high diver.
I'm not falling for anybody.
You're falling for somebody.
right. Now, I want you to arch your back more and you get a service faster, you understand? Okay. Otherwise, you're doing all right. Come on, it's only 75 feet. Now, let's see you do a really good one.
There's a little present. You go get dried off. Over to the tent, I got something for you.
Tonight?
Sure, you're gone off the top tonight.
Shouldn't I try it just once?
You only hit the top once in your whole life, Willie. After that, it's never the same. There's only one way to hit the top the first time. Right out there where the music's playing and everybody in the whole world is watching.
Yes, but...
Here, take this.
Go ahead. Just one.
Go on, take it. We'll relax you. There. Now you go onto your tent and lie down. I'll wake you when it's time.
But what?
Go on, Willie. That stuff hits you fast. I'd think you were crazy.
Mein Damen und Herren, jetzt das Wunder der Wundershow. Ein Mann, ein Ereignis, der große Kolonie. I should have said the Grossen Colonies.
Thank you.
Look off the town, Willie. Enjoy this feeling. Look at those lights. You'll see other cities, other towns, shining like that in the night. They'll be way up here, cool and far away and high, looking down on them, never letting them touch you. This is the moment I've been waiting for. I love you very much. And I wanted to tell you up here, on your first night. I love you, Willie. I want you to marry me. You can tell me later. Now, you're on your own. Music's over. The act is on.
Something happened tonight which makes me very unhappy. Frank asked me to marry him.
What? The cheese eater wants to marry you? Well, what do you know? Why should you be unhappy?
Because he's in love with me and I don't love him.
Well, maybe you should learn to love him.
What do you mean by that?
That Wisconsin hillbilly should have a good watch stashed away by now. You could do a lot worse.
But sure. What,
You mean about us? Look, we're not gonna let a little thing like you being married come between us.
If you ever touch me again, kill you.
Said, there's good news today. The show's a big hit, and we got a brand new star. And here she is, the other half of the team of the Great Colonies.
Thank you. Thank you very much. This is the happiest day of my life. Not only because I really feel a part of the show now, but because from now on, the Colonies are not just going to be a team. They're going to be Mr. and Mrs. too.
Thank you.
you doing here?
I'm here on an assignment for Life magazine.
It's wonderful.
Aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, excuse me. Willie, this is Bill Vines. He was combat photographer assigned to our regiment when I was peeling spuds for company K. She's my new partner.
Hello, Willie. I didn't know Frank had such a good eye for partners.
Come on, everybody, kiss the bride. All right, stand in line and take your turn.
Here we go. All right, next.
You're getting a swell guy. All the luck in the world.
Thank you. Look, Grandpa. Grandpa, you too.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Come on. Come on. Kiss the bride.
Yes,
lift her up so we can all see it, Grandpa.
Come on, next.
Who's next?
What do you want?
Nothing, I guess. Just thought I'd drop over and see how you're doing, how things are going.
They go very well, and you shouldn't be here.
Guess you're right, but... baby, I never see you alone anymore.
You saw me alone. You could see me alone for the rest of your life. And you didn't want it that way.
I know. I made a mistake. I made it, but it doesn't mean I have to like it, does it?
No. There's nothing I can do about it now.
I guess not. Oh, there is. There's one thing you could do for me. You see, I get myself in a jam, and I need a couple $100. But maybe you could let me have it.
I haven't got it.
What do you mean you haven't got it?
Frank takes care of our money. I haven't got it.
That... thanks anyway. Baby. Something else I need. You've got it.
Oh, no, Joe. Okay, maybe I can get the money for you. As soon as I can, maybe tonight, maybe tomorrow. You've got to go.
All right. I'll see you tonight. Meet me at the carousel. Better make it about 12 o'clock. You'll be asleep by then.
Oh, you're cursed. Frank finds you here, I don't know what he'll do to you.
I'll take that chance. See you tonight.
Hello, Mrs. Kalani.
Hello.
I saw him come out of here, you dirty little cheat. And if you ever do it again,
quiet.
Hello, Frank.
Hi, Peggy.
See you later, doll. So long.
What was she doing here?
Barring threat. I don't like these Sunday afternoon shows. I like the lights when I'm dark.
Better get dressed. We go on in 20 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet the wonder of our show, the Fire Eater Extraordinaire. Captain Snyder, he eats with swords and fire.
If you look at the tank, it's dangerous.
I know.
Nothing bothering you, is there?
No, I just made a mistake. Why should anything be bothering you? Look, Joe, I haven't got the money. I couldn't think of a way of asking him without it seeming strange.
Don't you know where it is?
No, I never asked.
What a dame are you? You don't know where your husband keeps his money.
Look, I'll find some other way to get the money. I've got to go back.
I don't want you.
No, get away from me. I told you I'd kill you, and I will.
What's the matter with you? Talking about you, kill me. I knocked you down and kicked you. You wouldn't do anything about it. You couldn't, because you're in love with me. You couldn't help yourself.
Joe, you hurt me.
Baby, nobody else is ever going to come close to you again except me. Nobody ever. You're going back there and you're going to get that money and you're going to bring it to me. And we're going to leave together, you and me.
Thank you.
Five. Five, but it doesn't do any good. Until I met you, I never knew how rotten I was.
If you're rotten, we're both rotten. Two of a kind. We belong together. Don't fight it.
Come here, Willie.
Go to your tent.
Go to your tent.
He's leaving the show, Charlie. Tonight.
If I ever see you again, I'll really finish the job.
I don't want no trouble on my show, Joe. You better pack your things. Come by my tent. I'll give you your money.
Show tomorrow.
We're going to the States and buy a farm and live on it. And work on it with our own hands. Till you're so tired you won't have any ideas of playing around.
I won't go.
You'll go wherever I tell you.
Do you think you can move me around like some farm animal? You can't. I'm not an animal. I'm a human being.
You don't act like one.
I won't go. I don't love you. I won't go with you. I hate you. I hate every man in the world, and I hate you most of all. I don't belong to you. I don't belong to you or anyone else. And I want my money. I earned it. You have no right to keep it for yourself.
I'm not keeping it for myself. I'm saving it for you.
Then where is it?
You
must. Why don't you show it?
You must think I'm very stupid.
Oh, it, honey. Come on, guys. All I want is my money. I won't go with you, and I want my money.
Shut up and go to bed!
Sorry. I'm really not much good, Frank. But if you want me, I'll try to be a decent wife to you. Whether it's here or in that state where you want a farm or anywhere else.
But I might just as well be here.
I guess that's what comes of being a bachelor so long. I've done everything myself, my own way. Sometimes I forget that I'm not alone anymore. But I'll try to be a good husband for you, Willie.
When will the pictures be published?
Maybe never. I haven't got an order for the assignment yet, but I think they'll like them. Especially if you'll open the cape a little.
Oh, I hope this shows up in the picture. Frank gave it to me today. Real diamonds.
Beautiful. Any special occasion, a birthday or something?
No. No birthday. That's a very special occasion.
Mel and my assistant and I will be popping up all over the place, but it'll all be this flash stuff, so just play like we're not alive, okay?
Fine. Ein dominant Herren! Jetzt das Wunder der Wundershow! Die großen Kolonies!
No, not at all, Bill.
No, no, no. Thank you very much. You've been very nice.
I wish there was something I could really do for you. I mean, I really do.
No. I think all I need now is a little rest.
Nice funeral, Willie. Nobody could ask for any better.
Yes. Sure, Frank would have thought it was a lovely funeral.
You get some rest. You'll feel better in 2 or 3 days.
Charlie, why did everyone act so strange at the funeral? No one came near me. No one spoke to me. It's been that way ever since he died.
Why worry about them? They're nothing but a bunch of characters anyway.
As if they think I killed him.
Oh, you ought to know better than that. Gab, gab, that's all they ever do. It was an investigation, it was an accident, and that's that. Besides, if they didn't have this to talk about, they'd find something else.
I suppose so.
Willie, I've got a little business I'd like to talk over with you. Frank's will. He made it out the day after the wedding. You get everything, Willie. I think it's a little more than you'd expect. $5,000 cash money. Been saving for years for a little farm. It says you'll find it in the top of the trunk, in back of the mirror. As I'm sort of responsible, I'd like to have you look, see if it's all there. Yeah?
All right.
Count it and see if it checks out?
No. Frank said that was $5,000. That's what there is. My whole life dreamed of having money. I was much more modest than my dreams. 5,000 marks was all I wanted. Now I have $5,000. And I don't want it.
Of course you don't. I understand, honey. But Frank wants you to be happy. Why don't you look at it that way?
Charlie, I really have to get some rest.
Okay. I'll go.
Pictures will sell a lot of tickets. I'll show them to the gang.
Poor Frank. Even when he's dead, he makes money for Charlie.
He made money for me, too. I got an awful big check for that layout, Willie. You see, people like those pictures. They dramatize death. It gives them a thrill, even in a photograph, to see Frank falling.
Perhaps.
Do you know why they'll come now? Because they'll be waiting for you to fall. They'll want to be sure not to miss it when you do.
Has it ever occurred to you, Bill, that people might like to see diving just because they like diving?
Not a dive like you make. They're waiting for you to make a slip. They want to see you dead. I want to see you alive. Tell me about Frank and you.
Not much to tell. We met, fell in love, just like that. Then we weren't alone anymore. We did everything together because we couldn't stand to be separated even for a single minute. That's why we became partners. We were very happy.
Well, at least he had that.
No. He hadn't. I'll tell you what he had. Really had. He picked me up out of the cook tent. He taught me how to earn a living. He made a performer out of me. He loved me and he married me. By way of thanks, I betrayed him. I broke his heart. And in one way or another,
this heel.
You take me home, please.
Sure.
No, please, don't get out. I feel like being alone. Thank you so much.
Good night.
I didn't want to come around any earlier. I was real sorry to hear about Frank.
Were you?
Well, of course. Honey, like somebody you know. I heard you were terrific your first dive after it happened.
I had a good teacher.
Yeah.
How's Peggy?
Peggy? She left me. I don't know. Well, I guess I better be going.
Where are you going?
Haven't made up my mind yet. Doesn't much matter.
If you wanted it, I think I could get Charlie to give you your old job back.
No, baby. You're doing all right now, and I want you to I'm no good for you.
Joe.
Charlie to come to my tent as soon as he can. It's very important.
Sure, right away.
Thanks.
See me?
Yeah. Sit down. There's something we haven't talked about.
Yeah? What's that?
My new salary. You were paying Frank 200 and me 125. That's 325 for the whole act, right?
Yeah, well, you see,
from now on, the act only costs you 300.
I was thinking around 200, and then maybe a little later.
It's 300, Charlie, or I don't go on. And I'm not joking.
No, I don't believe you are.
It's settled?
Yeah.
By the way, you haven't seen Joe around this morning, have you?
Joe? No, why? I didn't even know he was back.
He was.
Is there anything wrong, Willie?
Not a thing. Why?
I was just wondering. The way you held me up for that $300 just now. It wasn't like you, Willie.
It's going to be like me from now on, Joe. I'm turning smart. Very smart.
You don't have to convince me.
Colony. You can tell tell them tonight I'll dive like Frank did. I'll do the somersault dive.
Gee, that's great, kid, but do you know what you're doing?
You're proving the act, Charlie. That's what I'm doing. And after the dive, you come to my tent, and we'll talk about money. More money, to be exact.
I'm Dominant Heron. Frau Coloni, das erste Mal in a somersault dive. I'm Salto Mortale.
Says you're going to be great. It'll take a little while, but you're going to be all right. Attached to headquarters. I was snapping a photograph of some VIP 75 miles behind the front one day when a flashbulb exploded in their face. I always felt they should have given me the Purple Heart for it.
I like it. Gives you a sort of a sporty. I like very much.
Willie, I want to ask you a question. That's why I brought you here. It's a very important question, isn't it?
Bill, I can't. I just can't. I might even want to, but I can't.
You're throwing away an awful lot of years. It might be good for us both.
I know. I'd probably be sorry for it the rest of my life. I've never brought good fortune to anybody. Least of all to myself.
Are you sure it isn't Joe? Do you still love him?
I don't know what love is.
I think you love me.
People watching.
No. Entschuldigen Sie mich, Frau. Telefongespräch für Sie aus Frankfurt.
Danke. I'll be right back.
How much?
5 marks.
Dankeschön. Ja, bitte, wer spricht?
Charlie. Oh, how are things going?
Not so good, Willie. I thought we'd do better here in Frankfurt. The most important thing is, how are you?
I'm fine. The doctors say they're going to throw me out of here at the end of the week.
You need that too. She's getting out of here, all right, but she's not coming to Frankfurt. She quits, see? She's through. You can take that diving tower and you can sell it to the junk dealer.
But to tell you the truth, Charlie, I probably won't be coming back. I think I have other plans. Nice plans.
Just a minute. There's somebody here wants to talk to you. Just a minute.
Hi, Willie.
Yes. Yes, I'm much better. Thank you. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Your attention, please. The passengers of flight 418 from Munich to Frankfurt will enter through gate number 2. Achtung, Achtung, die Passagiere des...
Oh, I knew you'd come back.
This show is really nothing without you.
Oh, come on. Show you a chance.
Where's Joe?
Well, he's in town trying to drum up some business.
Very much alike, you and I. We have good things in us. Lots of good things. They're trapped there. They can't come out. Thank you. Hello, Joe.
Guess I've got a little explaining to do.
No. Everything's all right, Joe. Let's just forget it.
forget it. I want to talk to you. Could I come back to your tent after the show?
Sure, Joe. I'd like to see you.
I'm Dominant Heron. Jetzt das Wunder von der Wunderschau. Die große Kolonie.
Follow me. If I were right for you, I would have come back.
Joe's here. Did you come to Frankfurt to see him?
Yes, I did.
Please believe me, I'm not running after you. I just want to be around if you need me.
Look, I have to be alone now, Bill. Don't follow me, please.
You were terrific. You're great. That took a lot of guts. I couldn't have done that. I mean, go back up there after what happened.
Thank you.
Willie. I know what I did was a real lousy thing to do, and I'm sorry. The only thing I can say is I want to make it up to you.
You want to give me back the money?
Why, sure, baby, sure. But I want to do more than that. Look. Without you, this show wouldn't be worth a penny. You know that. And what's Charlie paying you? Peanuts. I can show you how to make some real dough. You know what you should be getting? A piece of this outfit. And I mean a big piece. And I'm going to see that you get it.
Sounds fine, Joe. Is that all you're interested in?
Baby. You know better than that.
It doesn't work anymore.
What's the matter with you, you nuts? What are you talking about?
I'm free of you. I didn't think I ever would be. But I am.
Look, baby. I don't blame you for being sore about the money.
The money?
No, Joe. I'm only sorry it couldn't have been put to some decent use. Instead of being carried off to the sewers by filth like you.
Now, just a minute. Just hold it. You can be sore, but... you or no other dame's gonna talk to me like that. Now,
Let's stop this nonsense. Come here.
I won't.
You'll do as I tell you to do.
Not anymore, Joe. That's all over. If you were starving to death and howling for food, I wouldn't throw you a rotten bone.
I know what you're trying to prove, but knock it off. It won't work. You're stuck with me, baby. And you know it. Whatever I am, we're both made of the same kind of stuff.
We are not. I'm not dirty like you. When I stole your money, I was hungry. Whatever I've done wrong shames me. But you, you love to wallow in the mud. You've been paid in full. Now get out of here.
Get out of here. Get out? You could stand there just like that and tell me to get out? You think, after what I did, do you think I fixed a bar on Frank's ladder for you to tell me to get out of here? Yeah, I did that. I did it because I couldn't stand to be without you. I did it for us, because we belong together.
You killed Frank?
No, no, not me. We did it. The two of us, the both of us. Yeah. And that's what everybody will think. Yeah. And I'll let them think it. Yeah. Now. Now tell me to get out of here.
Get out! Did it for me. And I'll tell them so. But you must go with them now. Then you will not need those. He will go with you now.
Oh, troppo.